Are you crying? That hurts.
For 2 years, we've been dealing with a global pandemic. Some of us have done better than others.
Forgot my mask.
You may have thought that it would be over by now, but unfortunately, that's not the case. COVID-19 is still spreading rapidly worldwide. Will it ever end? And what can we expect in 2022?
Let's have a look.
This is your body on COVID-19 2022. The Economist estimates that by the end of 2021, COVID-19 had killed as many as 20 million people.
That can't be right.
Thankfully, almost 3 billion people managed to get fully vaccinated. But then, a new variant appeared that spread faster than ever. The Omicron variant. Should we expect more COVID-19 variants in 2022? Or is this our new normal?
That better not be.
Vaccines and treatments. As more of us get vaccinated, the burden of COVID-19 on our healthcare system will decrease. By the middle of 2022, there will be several vaccines available for use, enough to vaccinate everyone in the world. But lower-income countries will still have a hard time getting enough needles into their citizens.
Who has access to abortion lines?
Today, scientists are working on new vaccines that will work simultaneously on multiple strains of the virus. They're even developing a pan-respiratory vaccine that would work on both coronaviruses and influenza. Trials with antiviral pills show they could reduce hospitalizations by as much as 30%, though scientists were hoping for better results. These new pills work by preventing the virus from replicating. However, monoclonal antibody treatments could reduce the risk of severe disease by up to 85%.
Wow.
But these treatments will be more expensive and need to be taken via a drip. And if you're worried your kids might catch COVID-19, Pfizer anticipates federal authorization in 2022 for kids under 5 to get vaccinated. Variants. COVID-19 variants like Delta and Omicron will continue to emerge in the coming years. With each new mutation, the potency of the antibodies you've developed will diminish, and the infectiousness of the variants will grow. So, why has the Omicron variant become the dominant strain? Well, it's because it can still infect people with immunity to the Delta variant. And it multiplies 70 times faster than Delta and the original version of the virus. Even double vaccinated people are at risk. That's why it's important to get a booster shot. Although Omicron's symptoms are often milder, it's crucial to remember that all the other strains are still out there and infecting people. So keep wearing your mask and washing your hands. The more people that get fully vaccinated, the lower the chance for COVID-19 to be life-threatening. And the hope is that eventually it will not be as virulent. Long haul. As 2022 continues, we'll get a better idea of the long-term effects of COVID-19. Some people who have contracted COVID-19 haven't fully recovered. Many of them, known as long haulers, continue to suffer long-term effects. And in some cases, conditions such as loss of smell and taste only appear many months after infection. As we become more aware of the long-term effects of the virus, new treatments will become available to help those in need. The future. Now, at the beginning of 2021, vaccines had just started to become available, yet many believed that COVID-19 would be on its last legs by the end of the year. Instead, a new wave appeared, infecting more people than ever. Will 2022 be different?
Good question.
Will we finally see the end of lockdowns, masking, and vaccinations?
Probably not.
Well, masks will likely still be required for the next few years. Don't worry, there are many fashionable options out there. And like the flu shot, annual boosters will likely be in our foreseeable future. Some experts have said that the pandemic may end in 2022, but others say that it won't become a seasonal occurrence like the flu until the year 2025. Only time will tell when and if COVID-19 will become a memory. Vaccinations will play a large part in the future of COVID-19. You can find out more on another episode of Your Body On.